And so the progressive education movement was, you know, this part of it, I think, that at least for a period, was common in American education. I think we're going backwards again now, but had become a major part of what American education has been generally. But Studer and the people who built Woodland were also radicals within the progressive education movement, in that they didn't see that the classroom was solely going to be the repository of all these changes, but they wanted to connect what was going on in the classroom to larger social political changes. And Studer and most of the other adults who were involved in Woodland were participants in what was a very large communist-led radical movement of the 1930s. Now, this becomes hard historically because generally the view is that we want to exclude communists from any discussion of American history, that they can't have contributed anything, and therefore we just won't talk about them. And the way this works, and I've been sort of watching how this happens, and partly because I, you know, tried to write a book about it but didn't take this perspective, was that people say, well, the communists were all narrow-minded and dogmatic. That's why we don't like them. And somebody like myself will say, well, but they weren't all narrow-minded and dogmatic. And they say, well, they weren't really communists. So they thought they were communists. You're not a communist. You don't like communists. How are you to define what a communist is? They thought they were. Shouldn't we take their word for it? Because, yes, they were narrow-minded and dogmatic communists. They're narrow-minded and dogmatic everything. That's one of the possibilities that people have whenever they get into groups. But there are also people who were not. And Studer and Kazin and some of the others who were communists. I'm not using the term. I don't know whether they paid dues, but I don't have the, never looked at the financial records. And I think the focus on whether they paid dues or not is kind of an American Activities Committee question. Did you really pay dues? If you didn't really pay dues, then you weren't a communist. That, historically, that doesn't make sense. People were part of a network of people and ideas who were, took their general political sensibility from the activities of the Communist Party during the 1930s and 40s. It was very broad.
When I was in the Army, I was put in a, after basic training, I was put in a barracks with mostly Hispanics, one other guy, his name was Earl Browder. And his crime was he had the wrong parents.
Right.
My crime at the age of 19 was I had been too radical. And that's why we were together. And the military, when they investigated me, wanted to know, do I have Pete Seeger records? I had a hearing in which they wanted to know if I still... They knew that I had purchased them at a town hall. I don't know how they knew, but they knew that I had purchased them. They wanted to know if I still had them.
I first saw Pete Seeger in concert when I was in 1959, and it was about 20 kids sitting in a children's concert at Brandeis University outside of Boston. I last saw him 2 years ago on his 90th birthday when he was in front of 10,000 people at Madison Square Garden. I mean, that's not bad, right? I mean, it really is not bad for somebody who has been vilified most of his life.
Yeah.
You know, so there's these streams can work, right? People have to stick at it. And Pete's really good, because you stick at it for 90 years, something's going to happen, right? Most of us won't make 90, but after 90 years, something's going to happen, right?
As you were alluding, and several other people were, that as people came out of that, it opened their consciousness to other ways of thinking, or the hallucinogenics, or resisting authority. So it made them more open to the agenda of the left, mm-hmm. if you want to call it that. I don't know where it got us, but that's the way I see it.
Greg? But if you talk about the agenda of the progressive movement, which many of us cut our teeth on, it is easy to look at the Catholic culture and say, this is perfect for the reactionaries. Give them enough drugs and start giving them religion.
Yeah.
It is literally the opiate.
Just this last year, and teaching kids songs and singing with them, but teaching them to write songs. And these kids got into a hell of a lot of trouble, fourth graders, because they were singing on the walls, they were singing where they wanted to. At one point, even the cops were called on them. And they wrote the song that said, you know, people think we don't have anything to say until we're old enough to vote, but we've got to sing out loud, and we've got to sing what we believe. So these little, however old they are, that's the continuity that's still going on. That's what I feel like is the legacy of Camp Woodland.
And Seeger still causes trouble.
Let's hope so.
You know, there has to be some remnants left from all legends. There has to be.
Yeah,
I think all of us here have those remnants. I remember my husband being part of the first four boys, and they were very, very strong in their desire to make a better world. When a person was dispossessed from their apartment, they waited for these guys who moved the furniture down to go away, and they were there bringing them back up. You cannot lose that remnant. You cannot lose it. It's in all of us. And I think we're trying to give to our kids, whether they're going to listen or not. But we are very, very vocal and vital at this stage of the game.
And that history actually is important. There's a group in Boston called City Life that started doing the same thing in response to the foreclosures. But they took people's furniture back in when the bail was paid for that. And they didn't invent it. They knew that's what they did in the 30s, and they said, oh, we can do that too.
I'm not worried about the counterpointed kosher. I feel that I have a recipe that I can share.
Yeah, that's good.
Endless skyway. Below me. Golden Valley.
This land was made for you and me.
I roamed and rambled. What are my footsteps? Sparkling sand.
Diamond deserts.
All around me.
And all around
voices sounding. Sing it out.
This land.
Everybody knows the chorus. This land is your land.
This land is your land. This land is my land. From California to the New York Island. From the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters. This land was made for you and me.
There's a couple of verses did not get in the school song. I'll teach them to you. In the squares of the city, in the squares of the
city,
by the shadow of the steeple,
by
the relief office,
I saw my people
as they stood there hungry.
I stood there whistling.
What it was like.